Well, it was a unique game. The way we started fast, they got in back into it with a couple big plays, kind of boring second quarter. And then, great second half. And I'd like to come out and play like we've played second halves many times at the start of the game, but we'll take it any way we can get it.
South Dakota State defeated Missouri State 49-24 on Saturday, improving to 5-1 in Missouri Valley Football Conference play and 6-3 overall. As Stig alluded to, the Jacks jumped out to a 14-point lead on Missouri State, only to see the Bears tie the game later in the quarter.
It's difficult to play great football, 11 guys at a time for 60 minutes, but that's still the goal. And if you boil it down, it's one guy doing his job every play, put 11 of them together, put it together for 60 minutes. I've pushed them to be perfect. That's too much pressure. Let's just play the best football we can.
SDSU churned out more than 200 yards on the ground and scored 6 rushing touchdowns on Saturday, a team effort by 4 guys, 2 by Brady Mangarelli, 2 by Isaac Wallace, and 1 each by Mikey Daniel and Kyle Paris.
Really happy with the running game, happy with the fat guys blocking. People didn't notice, but that up front of Missouri State's was hard to block. They did a lot of twisting, slanting, and so did a great job with scheme. Really happy with those final two guys, Mikey Daniels and Kyle Paris, getting some touchdowns.
Defensively, other than the 2 big hitters by Missouri State, John Stiegelmeier's bunch played very well.
We did. I mean, our defense played really, really well, except for 2 plays, and those were 2 touchdowns. I mean, they had a couple drives other than that, but our guys rose up. We put pressure on the quarterback. We handled the jet sweep eventually. I thought we played pretty well.
In the third phase of the game, special teams played exceptional. The Jacks' kickoff coverage has been very good for a majority of the season.
You know, Coach Dickert and Coach Schleichner really asked our special teams guys to rise up in our coverage units because of their return guy. And our kickers put the ball where it was supposed to be, and our cover guys did their job. And really happy with Brady and Sam.
Individually, several players recorded achievements and set new marks versus the Bears. Let's start with Taryn Christian, who set the new single-season record for total offense. Through just 9 games, the Sioux Falls product is already at 3,163 yards.
Yeah, Taryn's having a great year. Our offense is having a great year. He's got some, good fat guys in front of him, some really good receivers. The fact that he's setting records and looking at more records is a credit to himself, but also everybody doing their job. Really happy with their production.
Jake Winicky, who already has set the receiving yards and touchdowns mark at SDSU, is now the all-time receiving yards leader in Missouri Valley Football Conference history.
Jake has had a phenomenal career here, and we say he's only a junior. Well, he was only a freshman when he just caught so many balls and had so many yards, and it's just a credit to the whole offense, but the type of young man he is continues to work to get better.
And last but not least, we have Dallas Goddard, who went over 1,000 yards receiving in a season. He's the first tight end to do so.
Yeah, I'm really happy with what Dallas has done. He's worked tremendously hard to accomplish what he's accomplished. Obviously, he's an excellent student athlete. I think with all those other records and all those things, he also maybe leads the school in one-hand catches right now.
So now we turn the page to this week and for the final regular season home game at Dana J. Dykehouse Stadium. SDSU welcomes in-state rival South Dakota for the South Dakota Showdown Series presented by South Dakota Corn. The Jacks have had the Coyotes number the past few seasons in a rejuvenated rivalry series.
Yeah, I think it's really neat that the rivalry of USD and South Dakota State also funds or helps fund Feeding South Dakota. What a great organization. My wife and I support that and really believe in it. And hopefully it's just not about the rivalry, but coming together to make a difference in a lot of people's lives.
The Coyotes are a much improved team this year, starting Missouri Valley Conference play at 3-1, but they've dropped 2 heartbreakers the past 2 weeks. First-year head coach Bob Nielsen has done a great job in his first year on duty.
Well, Coach Nielsen's a really good football coach. He's a proven football coach. Every place he's been, they've won. I think the University of South Dakota stepped up and gave him some things that the old staff didn't have and made it possible. His kids believe in his system. The coaches, they're playing hard. They play good offense, good defense. It's going to be a battle.
South Dakota quarterback Chris Strebler, who transferred into the program this year from Minnesota, is having a great season. He's thrown for 1,500 yards and 18 touchdowns, while running for nearly 700 yards and 7 touchdowns.
Their quarterback's a phenomenal player. You know, he's the best runner on the field. He's got the ability to throw the ball. They spread you out. They run a lot of what I call communist football. And so credit to them. They're using him to the max.
Stig says the team won't approach the game differently from any other, and his squad's goals remain the same.
We still have our goals in front of us, and the goal this week is to be 1-0, and not to think about what that accomplishes down the road. But we need to be ready for the rivalry game. We need to be ready for a great crowd to help us out. It would be tremendous to walk out into this stadium and see it full, and see it full of blue shirts and yellow shirts and individuals that come to help mark and make a difference in this game.